heroes from the movies you grew up with. And you say to yourself, I can do that. I've played roles like that up on the stage. I've played that 40s detective or that drill sergeant. That rebel without a cause. Or that boxer without hope. Except his two fists a dame in a bottle. I can do it. But, you go out there for the auditions and the casting calls and, the only roles for Asian actors in television and film are, two-line, two-bit character parts that don't even think. They're the background. The color. The help. They're, waiters that do laundry, cooks that never learned to ride a horse. Killers from another country, soldiers with no balls, that make no choices, that have no substance, no nothing. Kind of like all the odd jobs I did to keep myself in this business, so I could get up on stage once in a while and play a real, live, feeling, thinking human being. And you see, the problem is producers and writers, while they have certain ideas about what we're about, they see us as a place where they do lunch, someone that gave him a bad time with a root canal. They just don't want to get to know us. They're afraid of us. My own agent is afraid. Like in Hollywood, it's a look. It's all American, blonde hair, blue eyes. You see, my agent won't send me out unless the breakdown says Jap, Chink, Gutka, Viet, ass kissing, kung fu fighting, chop chop till you drop. God damn, why can't it just say male? I'm not one of those actors that can just, sit by the phone and wait for a career boost, I gotta keep busy, I gotta do something. And I guess that's why I still write. It's how I started in this business, as a writer. It's one of the things that's kept me sane. And the other has been theater. Theater, it's my outlet. My workout. My one true love. Well, how are we all doing tonight, eh? Good. We got any Japanese people in the audience? Yeah? Well, I can sympathize with each and every one of you, because I grew up Japanese, and let me tell you, it's not easy growing up Buddha head in this country. Did you have Japanese parents? So did I. They're nuts, right? They're nuts. First big day of life, kindergarten, what do? They shop for your clothes at Sears, they get your shoes at Kmart, then they strip out any hair. Have a good time at school today, learn something. Yeah, Mom, today I learned that only monks and mass murderers get this haircut. Shit. We used to call it a bozu haircut. I always thought that was the name of a famous Buddhist priest or something. Then I found out it just meant bald, right? And kids can be a little rough on you. They'll say things like, if your nose holes were bigger, we could use your head as a bowling ball. Hey, who cut your hair, your gardener? Even the teacher wouldn't give me any respect. During a geography lesson, she'd take my head and use it as a model of the globe of the world. Listen up, class, here's Russia. Here's the equator. And here, this is where we are, San Francisco, And discipline with Japanese parents is a little bit different, too. It's called judo class. Okay, you're 7 years old. You're fucked up. You can't speak any Japanese. And the judo instructor is a 10th degree black belt maniac from Kyoto who totally loves to throw little boys around at the tummy mat for a couple of hours. And as you get older, discipline changes too. It's called golf lessons with your father. Approach the ball.
Okay.
Get that grip right.
Okay.
Keep that left arm firm. Swing! You missed. But your head came up, your right hand came through, and you're holding it like a baseball bat.
Please, I'll be good, all right? Just don't take me to the driving range again. Send me to karate class, I can deal with that.
But my old man did redeem himself, though. That's because he took us to samurai movies when we were young. Yep, every Saturday night, we catch the latest samurai flick at the Toho. And those guys were bad. Nakadai. Kinosuke. Hashizo. That blind dude, Satoichi. And the John Wayne of our people, Toshiro Mifune, and Mifune was bad. I mean, he would duel it out, right? With 50 bad guys. By himself. At night! In 2 feet of snow! But there'd be an arrow stuck in his left thigh! He'd be carrying a small child. His castle burnt down. His father beheaded. His mother's sepulchre. You know, I mean, it started raining. 70 mile an hour winds. And then the bad guys would cheat. They'd take out guns. No, cannons! He'd lose an eye. His sword would break. But he'd win. Mifune was amazing.
Comes out of nowhere!
asshole fucking me?
Never pick on a pussy unless you have a tiger by the tail.
What the hell does that mean, Master? I don't get it.
Well, Grasshopper, have you cut the insect shit?
I said, this guy's bugging me.
Well, quite Chinese.
And the name is Carradine, David Carradine. You know I'm only half Chinese.
Take the pebble from...
Oh, you fucked the pebble already? I said, this guy's about to kick my ass. And then Bourbon Breast swings at me like he wants to kill all of China. And I'm flashbacking again to my karate sensei, who used to tell me, never get angry when you spar because your mind is clouded. The rest of the throw, instincts are gone.
And I always wondered what the hell he was always grumbling about.
And I flash back into the kids at the playground, who used to sing, Ching Chong Chinaman! Ching Chong Chinaman!
And I didn't know anyone named Ching or Chong. The only one I knew was Cheech and Chong.
And then this overgrown Spuzz McKenzie shoves me back against the bar, and I go reeling back into, oh no, here comes another flashback!
Polite, my movie friends. Only this time, my carrot, he's being played by Senator Daniel in Nowhere!
And Dano, it's Andy Fumatai!
Where am I now? I'm at Ichijoji Temple with Miyamoto Musashi, and we're fighting off 100 warriors, and the wind is blowing through the reeds!
And my hair.
And I hear a voice. It's a woman's voice. Could it be? What's up? Stop it, Harry! Will you just chill out? He just bought me a drink!
Oh no. It's the blonde. And she pushes him out of the way. And off goes Spud, growling back. And she says she's sorry, but he just goes nuts when there's no beer nuts. So I tell her, no problem.
In fact, he was lucky.
To have you.
She smiles, and I smile, and then she
kisses me. So I say to myself,
because damn it,
what can I say? When you're 5'2", 118 pounds, of buttered beef and muscle, damn it, when you got it. Use it. Besides, it's Saturday night. I got it. Open. Season.
And later. Thank you.
I used to work for this Nisei company. And the guys from Japan used to tell me, you're not Japanese. And I go, sure I am, I'm Japanese. And they go, nope, you're American. I go, all right, you know, I was born here, but I'm Japanese American. My parents are Japanese. Right, we're all from Hawaii. They speak Japanese fluently. My grandparents are from Japan, that counts, doesn't it? Then they'd say, well, that means your sansei, third generation. I go, yeah? Well, there's a lot of Japanese in Hawaii. About 40% of the population. Then they go, well, Hawaii's Hawaii. I go, yeah? Well, then, how come Japan owns half of it now? Yeah, you always have a good time.
Meditating on the desks of E.F. Hutton executives, thumbing through streamers of ticket tape, listening to quarterly reports, checking computer readouts, dropping deposits. Yeah, he's a miracle. And his book of five rings is a bestseller. And paranoia is high. And Japan doors are slowly opening. And America is bullish on the diet. And Wall Street is worried. The New York Times and Newsday asks, who really won the war? Congresswoman Bentley says the U.S. is becoming a Japanese colony. Ronnie and Nancy got a 9-day package tour for a cool $2 million. And the Bush administration just wants to keep up with its ally, shake hands and make loan payments. Presidents of Nippon corporations know how to deal. They go by the book. They wrote it. The samurai approach to management. They will take care of their employees. They will plan for the future. They will research all options. They will learn 35 languages. They will move in on the market and they will boast high returns. They know how to deal. They can play the American game. They had good teachers after the war. Hershey bars eased a lot of children's pain in Hiroshima hospitals. Doublemint Juicy Fruit were made popular by GIs, along with Hapa Kids and War Brides. Yeah, America's amazed that anyone could survive the bomb. That 7 out of the 10 largest banks in the world are now based in Tokyo. That anyone could crawl out of the rubble. That multiculturalism means everything they're not. That anyone could survive the Holocaust. That the camps don't mean summertime. That anyone could rebuild themselves stronger. That the dollar has a yen. Yeah, it's amazing, amazingly simple. Simple methodology goes back for centuries. Nowadays, Cressidas and Maximas are filling garages in American suburbs. Jim McMahon and Grace Jones are selling Hondas. Toyotas are being manufactured in resurrected Georgetown, Kentucky. Oh, what a feeling. Mitsubishi has cut a new deal with Chrysler in Bloomington, Illinois. Yeah, they've come a long way since aerodynamic World War II Japanese Zero. Next stop, Radio City. Yeah, Japan has opened its doors to Musashi worshippers and made a killing on the market. Because Kansai is fashionable. Columbia is the one and only. Xerox is copying Canon. Kentucky Fried Chicken has hit the Ginza. Hong Kong is saying so long. IBM stock is in shock. Tiffany's is 24 karat Mitsubishi gold. Timex takes a licking, but Seiko keeps on ticking. Yeah, Musashi's a miracle. And his book of 5 rings is a bestseller. And paranoia is high. And business was never better. Ask Lee Iacocca. Sushi goes better with Coke.
You're a sight for sore eyes. How long's it been? 7 years? Damn, look at you. Will you look at you? You done grown some, haven't you? Yep, you should have been a linebacker for the Cowboys. They could sure use some talent in that prevent defense of theirs. Yeah, I told your mama, God rest her soul, we should have sent you to A&M. Made you an Aggies boy. Show the Pac-10 what true All-Americans are made of. I don't know why you won't go to that damn UCLA. What the hell's a Bruin anyway?
Dad, that's all in the past. I wanted to come out to the West Coast. Texas is too Republican.
Oh, hush your mouth, boy. I'll have you know it was a great day when we took over the presidency again. Get this country back to the stuff it's made of. Why, your very own Hollywood Ronnie has done wonders for the American dream. Gave us back our balls, not like your bleeding heart liberal dad.
What about housing? The homeless? Feeding the poor? What about Social Security? You know, you're not that young anymore, babe.
Oh, Angel, babe. And I can still take on you and your brothers with one hand tied behind my back, hopping on my left foot. What about that there Ayatollah, eh? The Shah. Them Iranians. Evil men like Noriega. Drugs just killing our youth today.
Dad, we haven't seen each other in years.
Let's not get into political debate on our first day. Let's just have a nice dinner and relax.
Oh, look at the place you're taking me to. Goddamn sushi bar. Oh, hell, I can't swallow the live fish. I make sure an animal's good and dead before I eat it. Not a goddamn boat person. I tell you what, son. Let's go find ourselves a black Angus, huh? Yeah, get ourselves a couple nice, thick, juicy USDA joint dad sushi is in. It's hip, it's healthy, it's high protein, it's low cholesterol, it's good for you. Hell, I don't want anything good for me! Trust me, Dad, you'll enjoy it.
Oh, I hate raw fish. I hate anything raw. I hear it moves in your mouth and wiggles on your tongue there.
Dad, they have more than just fish here, and not everything is raw.
Well, if you want fish, let's find ourselves an H-Salt Empire, huh? A fish and chip place.
It's deep fried, they give you taters instead of that stinky rice, and they got that there English malted beer.
We're going to have sushi, and that's final. I went to a lot of trouble to reserve us a place at the counter.
We gonna eat at the counter? Well, don't they got tables?
Okay, it's all part of the experience. To watch the chef's preparation of the dishes.
To observe the fresh quality of the cuisine.
It's like an art form coming to life
in front of your eyes.
It's too damn expensive is what it is!
Dad, I told you this is my treat. Now let's just go inside.
Hey, inside your deal, boy! What dirty thing you yelling at?
Oh, look there, please. He's just welcoming us into his establishment.
What in the hell's that?
That's an oshibori, Dad. A hot tub. To freshen up. To wash your face and hands.
I took a shower this morning. Oh, damn, that's hot! Jesus!
Dad, your voice. You quit swearing so much.
You know, you're getting mighty big for them britches of yours. Hey! I mean, you'll tell Tojo to lower his voice. He's the one doing all the damn yelling. What's he doing, welcoming us again?
No, Dad. He just wants to know what we like to drink.
Kato-san, futari sake kudasai.
Hai, dozo! What the hell, do you speak their lingo now? Damn, send your young into California and just speak some goddamn Oriental language. What the hell's the world coming to?
You know, you don't even sound like a true Texan anymore.
I should have known better when you picked me up in that damn AccuRite.
I only know a few key phrases. It's sushi bar talk. This is the 90s, Dad. Novell and Nine Grain are history. If you want to survive in the next decade, you better get with the program. And the menu for today is the Far East. Besides, the Acura is the most fuel-efficient trophy car in the market. Carbon Driver magazine rates it number one in America. Have some sake!
Look, son, I know a thing or two about this here sake.
That was in WW2, and don't you ever forget it.
And I did a little R&R in Tokyo. This here is a rice wine. Hell, I make everything out of rice. All we eat is fish. I hate it then, and my taste buds are still the same. Thank you, American. Oh, damn, that's hot! Jesus!
Wait, why don't you watch out? Listen, Cujo. My eardrums are beginning to hum here. Dad, please. His name is Kato. And he just wants us to order now.
Oh, I didn't know you knew him. Oh, he's a pushy little devil.
Kato-san, futari maguro to hamachi, unagi, California roll, and salmon skin temaki.
Hai! Dozo! You sound like a damn foreigner, son.
Did I just have some sake?
You know, this sake's not half bad. Smells like a backed up irrigation ditch. But you know it's got a kick like a black eyed mule, don't it? I bet you can find a still 10 miles away.
Hey, Taco-san, I'm another round of this here sake for me and my son.
Hey, Dozo, Dad, I told you, his name is Kato.
It's not Tocho. It's not Cucho. It's not Taco. It's Tato. And please lower your damn voice.
Well, long time to fucking Bronco. It wasn't my idea to grit here.
Hey, dozo.
Domo arigato, Kato-san.
You just said thank you. See, I know a few key phrases this here jargon myself. You remember courtship of Eddie's father?
Don't you touch your mustache, that there means welcome. Sayonara, that there means goodbye.
Or was it hello? Or was it I love you? Oh, what in the Lord's name is that?
That's unagi that. It's not raw. It's been broiled and there's a light teriyaki sauce on it. It's very good. Try it.
Oh, it does look good. What is it?
Sea eel.
Eel? Hey, unagi! Listen, Taro!
If you don't try this, you're gonna try this. This is good. Sea urchin.
Sea urchin. I thought sea urchins had them prickly things all over their bodies like a porcupine. No, I'll stick with a good one.
No, Dad, this is the meat inside of the sea urchin. It's like a shellfish, like a prawn or a crab.
You know, the zeal kind of tastes like chicken.
No, more like snake.
Yeah, like a rattler.
Do you remember the time Uncle Jake and I took you hunting? You wouldn't touch that snake until we told you it was rabbit. And bless your little heart, you looked up at us and said it kind of reminded you of bullfrog. You know, your Uncle Jake used to think that snake tasted more like possum. That's because it's got a wilder vibe to it. You don't like venison? What the hell did I just want? Jesus Christ. Give me some sake, sir. Oh, God. Feels like a nightcrawler's about to give me mouth-to-mouth regurgitation here.
Dad, are you okay? Here, have some sake. Why don't you try this? This is cooked. It's just a little crab and avocado. Oh, no, here. This is cooked. Salmon skin.
They just give you the skin. Why the hell didn't we just order from the same steak theater, partner? Oh, what Jesus' name is that?
That's an egg, Dad. It's been scrambled and cooked. It's very good. Try it.
That's an egg. Shaped like a goddamn rectangle. That ain't normal, son.
Oh, I'll be a fat turkey on a holiday? Hey, yo, bulldog, over here. Hey, Arkansas. I met that couple on the plane coming into town here.
Hey, you remember what I said now? When you're in my neck of the woods, don't you be a stranger.
Yo, rebel dog, you silly Razorbacks. Aggies, silly.
Tanto-san, click the check, please. Check, please.
Hey, Gozo. Oh, hey, Tanto. How about 2 more sakis for me and my son, and bring 2 sakis for that good old boy there and his missus.
Hey, and don't you step on your toe.
Oh, Jesus, Dad, I told you his name is Kato, and it's domo arigato.
You know, I knew this would happen. I thought maybe, just maybe, we'd have a nice quiet dinner, relax, and reacquaint ourselves. But no, I can't talk to you. I never could, and I never will.
Why the hell you think I moved out here to California in the first place, huh? To get away from you and your narrow-minded, racist, bigoted brothers, your white-holding friends, your religion, your politics, your son.
What happened to your voice?
Now that's my boy. Talking now. I don't believe it.
Kato-san, check please. Get your coat, Dad. We're getting out of here.
Well, son, wait up! Wait up, son!
Oh, well, hey there, Kato. Well, here, this here's for you, huh?
Mighty fine service you got here.
Thank you.
Nope.
Don't want what you got, though. And God bless you.
Son, will you wait up?
You old hound dog, you.
Son of a gun. Silly! Aggie!
Randy Kitagawa. I ran into him when I was applying for this job. It was a management training program at Bank of America years ago. And
Well, you see, Randy and I, well, we went to school together, and he was the guy that come to school, you know, and had a slide rule on his belt, and he knew how to use it. 58 pens and pencils there. You can see the white socks with his floods, you know? I mean, he wore plaid on top of stripes on top of plaid. Two pairs of glasses! Anyway, Randy's sitting there, you know, and he's filling out the application, and, well, he looked exactly the same as he did in junior high school, you know? Total nerd.
What a geek!
So I went to the window and I said, Randy, how are you doing, man? And he looked at me, and I could tell he didn't recognize me at all. And he said, excuse me? I don't think I know you.
No.
What are you talking about? It's me, Wayne Nishikawa. We went to school together, dude. He looked at me again, and he went, oh, I thought you were dead. I turned around and walked out of there, threw the application away, you know, because, well, I knew I wasn't dead. And, I wasn't going to apply for a job that Randy Kitagawa applied for.
That's for you.
West Coast Director of Corporate Community Multicultural Relations, Sapporo Beer Company, Los Angeles. Down to one of the final candidates. Did I really want to leave the world of non-profit theater? Did I really want to do that? Who wants a cushy corporate gig anyway? Hey, you try running a theater company with a $350,000 budget and your projected income is $175,000. That's a challenge. You try putting up a show with a $35,000 budget and you got about $2,000 startup. Then you gotta play hide the piggy bank in 3 different checking accounts because creditors are coming to your door the weekend after opening night because the reviews have hit the streets and they're good. Let me tell you that stress factor hits that maximum level all the time. I mean, you're constantly worrying, you know, about the budget, the rent, grant deadlines, which usually ends up as a midnight run to the post office. You worry about all the production costs, the lights, the set, costumes, props, sound equipment, and not only if you have it, but if it's going to work that week. Then you worry about getting the press releases out, the posters up, group sales, the mailings. Then the last thing to worry about, opening night. Nope! Then you gotta worry about the reviews, you gotta worry about audience attendance, you gotta keep the actors happy, you gotta keep the actors' union happy, you gotta keep the technicians happy, because there's very little pay, and the only real payoff is the show, and what it does to those people in the seats. After that, it's the next show! We're talking eccentric headache number 99 here! Oh, God. Okay. Then try directing. That's another beast. It's like being a parent before your time. Do you have kids? Do you? Imagine 30 of them in a room, going nuts all at once. You gotta change their diapers and then feed them lines. Okay? Imagine trying to cast a 9-character play, and you got about 25 people auditioning, and half of them can't even walk or talk at the same time. They're models! Oh, God! Then take the 9 kids that you did cast and spend 4 grueling weeks with them, making sure that they know their parts, that they know their beats, they got inner monologues, that they got motivation. Hey, I got your motivation right here. Do it like I said! Then you make sure that they look good, that they're lit well, that the sound sets the right mood so that all those elements come together for that one night, and then boom, it's out of your hands. Oh, God, you just pray that the actors don't freak, that they're gonna hit their marks, that you prepared them enough and didn't over-prepare them, and like I said, when it all comes together, you find yourself laughing at a line you heard 100 times. You can jerk a tear out of Attila the Hun, because there's no stopping a show that hits when that audience says thank you for the evening. You know, they know it's not easy. And there's a hell of a lot of support out there. See, they know that we give them a voice. It's a cultural voice. we do something that nobody else does.
And nobody else wants to.
And we give young people role models. And we give old people a memory that's going to last them a lifetime. But how do you compete? You know, with a buck. Turn the video of last year's box office smash. How do you compete with MTV and primetime? Microwave popcorn. And Haagen-Dazs. A warm fire. And the big wide screen.
Theater has outlasted every personal relationship I've ever had. Theater has also ruined every personal relationship I've ever had. You know, because of, God, all the hours that you put in, the different schedules you're on. She's day, I'm night. The late night after rehearsal note session with the director that usually ends up in a bar somewhere. The bringing home of your character and not being able to get rid of it for a couple of hours. Infrequency of pay. And again, like the worst thing is having to kiss or make love to another actress while you're in a relationship. What are you talking about, honey? No, I do enjoy that. What do you mean? She's married. It's fucking crazy, you know? And, you know, well, okay. After all this time, you know, I'm a little bit tired of being poor. You know, having no money. I mean, I've been in this business 15 years. What do I got to show for it? I got a 20-year-old car that should be a classic, but it doesn't even run. You know, it doesn't matter. I can't afford car insurance, you know, or to pay for registration, or the parking ticket. We're talking San Francisco here, you know. I don't have any credit. I would love to have an American Express gold card. I really would, you know. The only color I get is red. Red flag at TRW at the mention of my name. I mean, my girlfriend has now left me for my bank teller who won't cash my checks because the IRS has put a lien on my account, you know. I mean, my rent is now 6 months overdue, and I'm getting evicted next month if I don't come clean, and my landlord is a relative! And shit, I go nuts at night because I gotta watch bad movies on some local television station because they disconnected my cable and I can't afford sleeping pills. And if I gotta eat another cup of fucking top ramen, you know, with another boiled egg, Jesus Christ, I'll, and then boom, a residual check comes in the mail. Or your agent calls and says, hey, they want to use you as a butler and all my children. You still got that monkey suit, dude? Life, breath, I can live again for another 30 days. Thank you, Lord. I will never drink again.
I should have listened to my parents and gone to med school.
Don't you think that this anti-Asian thing is getting to be a little bit out of hand? I mean, the other night, I got mugged by a couple volunteers for Greenpeace. Do I look like an Arctic fisherman? You know, I think baby seals are cute, personally. We all grew up in Flipper. Okay, talk about offensive. Have you seen this new 976 number? Dial an Asian woman. 976 Asia. Give me a break. Hello, the other half Vietnamese, half Korean. Do you have twins? What kind of sleazeboy thought of that, huh? Okay. And all these jokes about us eating dog, our pets, right? Like I go home for Thanksgiving. Mom, are we gonna have turkey again? No. German Shepherd? Oh, my favorite! What's for dessert? Budo pie! Now we're talking! It's like a sea of
Barracuda heads. Stepping off the plane in Japan and being surrounded by all these Japanese men and women was incredible. I mean, on the way to Tokyo, you know, all the street signs, the advertising, the neon lights, the billboards, they're all in kanji. I couldn't read a thing. It was great. I looked at my sister and I said, "Hey, Terry, this is like a huge J-town." I mean, I didn't know what the hell I was gonna do or where the hell I was going. But I'll tell you something. I never felt better in my life being so lost.
It's actually,
is actually an affectionate term for Japanese. It was used to determine those Japanese that were born in Hawaii. Well, we had another term for those Japanese that were born stateside, Katon. I believe, see, this started during World War II, you know, when the all-Nisei battalions were formed in the American Army. Well, you see, during basic training, well, the Hawaii boys met up with the stateside guys and, they didn't really get along at first. So the Hawaii boys, the Buddha heads, called the stateside guys Katonks. Because they said they had hollow heads. When they hit them. Kind of like the sound, you know, of a coconut falling out of the tree there and hitting the ground. Katonk. It was an affectionate term.
Ready.
the Germans were digging in deep. We were backing them up against the wall. They didn't want to give up their real estate so easily. Yeah, they had the wars. Stand and fight. We had us. Take 3 years. Lost battalion, eh? October 25th, 1944. Those brothers from Texas? Felt kinda sorry for them, eh? Cut off from friendly lines, running low on ammo, no food, no water, and surrounded. One way or another, we wouldn't get them out of there, though. And they had booby traps everywhere. The machine gun nest with the trapdoor popping up behind you after you pass them. Screaming Mimis, launching rockets all around us. It was raining so hard and it was so cold, almost snowing. Hey, that's why the wounded guys went into shock so fast, you know, because of the cold. The bush forest was so thick you couldn't tell feet in front of you. I could die every minute, every second. Sheer willpower. When you come down to a combat to sheer willpower. Secure the three bonsai hills and all that was left was frontal attack, eh? You know, by 1400, we had only 17 riflemen and one sergeant left in our company. All the rest of you and all our officers had been killed. We got them out. We saved 211 of those boys from Texas out of their original 275. The 100th and the 442 suffered 814 casualties in 6 days. But we got them out. Yeah, I almost forgot that. I ran into this logger from the mainland, gay company, and he showed me a letter. Colonel Hanley wrote. You remember Colonel Hanley? Second Battalion? Well, you see, it seems that the editor of Colonel Hanley's hometown newspaper, a Mr. Charles Pierce, wrote an article that said he wondered where good Americans were buried in this country. So Colonel Hanley responded, and they printed it. It goes like this. Yeah. March 10th, 1945. Dear Charlie. Hey, I think you knew the book. Just received the Pioneer. And that's the name of the newspaper. Of January 20th. And noted the paragraph enclosed. Yes, Charlie. I know there's some good Japanese Americans. There are some 5,000 of them in this unit. They are American soldiers, and I know where some of them are buried. I wish I could show you some of them, Charlie. I remember one Japanese American. He was walking ahead of me in a forest in France. German machine gun fire took the right side of his face off, but it didn't stop him until he knocked out the nest. I recall another boy. 88mm gunfire had us pinned down, trying to get us for some time, and we were losing guys left and right. He led a squad of men and diverted the fire so we could move in on the guns. When they carried him back in on the stretcher, the bloody meat from the middle of his thighs hung over the end and dragged in the dirt, and all the bone parts were gone. I remember a sergeant, a Japanese-American sergeant, if you will, who had his back blown in too. What was he doing? Why, he was lying on top of an officer who had been wounded to protect him from shell fragments during a barrage. I recall one of my boys who stopped a German counterattack single-handedly. He fired all his BAR ammunition, picked up a German rifle, emptied that, then used a German Luger pistol he had taken from a prisoner. He stopped the attack and saved all of us, but they got him. I wish I could tell you the number of Japanese Americans who have died in this unit alone. I wish the boys from the Lost Battalion could tell you what they think of Japanese Americans. I wish that all the troops we have fought beside could tell you what they know. The marvel is, Charlie, that these boys fight at all. They are good soldiers, in spite of the type of racial prejudice shown by your paragraph. I
know it makes a good joke, but it's the kind of joke that prejudice thrives upon. It shows a lack of faith in the American ideal. Our system is supposed to make good Americans out of anyone. It certainly has done it in the case of these boys. You, the Liberal Legion Post, Hearst, and a few others, makes one wonder just what we are fighting for. I hope it is a racial prejudice. Come over here, Chai. I'll show you who's some good Japanese Americans. I'm very. Sign that. Colonel James Unhandy.
Realize that I go back for generations, hundreds of years.
You know, you read about people doing that, you know, making that trip back to their homeland. I mean, whether it's Asia or Africa or Europe or South America, anywhere, right? But you know, until you do, you don't realize, hey, I'm not just Sansei. I'm Buddha headed to the bottom.
Telling a joke in Japan is not that easy. Okay? Okay? Alright. Alright, I'm hanging out with a family friend. I've known him now 3 hours. We're tossing back a few drinks in his favorite karaoke bar. There's a slight language barrier. But I say, what the hell? I'll tell him a joke. Okay? Hey, Yukihiko, what do you get when you cross a Japanese guy and a black guy?
Oh no, we don't do that over here.
Use your imagination. Say a joke. What do you get when you cross a Japanese guy and a black guy?
I don't know.
Well, you get a guy on December 7th who has an incredible urge to attack Pearl Bailey!
Pearl Bailey?
No, no, Pearl Bailey.
But huh?
See what I mean? You gotta tell a joke over there. And the other thing that's a little bit tough to do is to confide in them, okay? Alright, we're hanging up.
Hey, Yook. You ever been in love, dude? Oh, yeah. Lots of guys. So in love that you knew she was the one.
Hey, Ichiban! Right! Black singer, man! See what I mean? You can't tell a joke over here. And the other thing that's a little bit tough to do is to confide in them, okay? Alright, we're hanging out another 3 hours. You know, we've tossed back a few more drinks.
Hey, Yook. You ever been in love, dude? Oh, yeah. Lots of guys. I mean, you ever been so in love that you knew she was the one?
Hey, Ichiban! Right!
Then you ever have Miss Ichiban
break up with you?
Break something?
Yeah, your heart! Break your heart and leave you for another guy!
Oh, I see.
That just happened to me, man. I came over here to Japan, you know? I don't know what the hell I'm gonna do.
Kill him!
Did I hear you right?
What are you talking about, man? This is 16th century feudalistic Japan, man. I can't just kill some dude because he took my woman. Kill her!
Wait a minute, don't you get it? That's the problem. I love her. I love her.
Kill yourself? Lighten up, you. Shit. Such an intense motherfucker.
Bartender! Do more study for me and Ron Ballard.
There's a road that goes from Tokyo all the way to Tokugawa Shrine in Nikko. And Tokugawa, right, he was like the baddest shogun Japan ever had, right? His family ruled 300 years. But see, back when they were building the shrine, one of Tokugawa's warlords had, in his honor, trees planted along this road.
their cryptomeria tree, Japanese cypress. And see, he had them planted on either side of the road, all the way from Tokyo to Nikko. We're talking 81 miles of trees, okay? And there's like about 23 miles of these trees left. And it's now been named the National Treasure of Japan, so you can't just walk this road anymore. But when you're at the shrine, and you look back down this road, these trees, man, they go, whew, as far as you can see. And they're tall. I mean, they're planted in the 1600s, so they're like 400 years old. I mean, these things are huge. I mean, they're taller than our redwoods. And see, I was told this was done as a lesson for the youth. That when you do something, see, you don't just think of today and your life. But when you do something, you think of the future and your country. Kind of like Sony planting those VCRs all over the world.
That's quite a message.
I was born again. The day my grandfather died and his soul rose to the heavens. I was born again. The day I stepped off the train at Hiroshima and felt ground zero. I was born again. The day we pilgrimaged to Manzanar and repaired the forgotten graves under the snow and the Sierras. I was born again. The day Tiananmen Square erupted like a bonfire of guilt and madness. The day the Berlin Wall crumbled down in the east and in the west. The day Mandela's voice could be heard again after 25 years of tears. The day the 442 returned. The day redress was passed. The day Kennedy asked what you could do. The day the king had a dream. The day feet were unbound. The day hands were unchained. The day hearts came home again. I was born again. We were born again. Asian. As American pie, it's here. We're gonna live and die. But as the years roll on, Asian America, where have you gone? What happened to all you politically correct, social conscious community activists who raised fists and minds with long speeches and long hair, with Red Guard slogans and mile jackets. From the fields of Delano to the dusty roads of Fresno, from Nihonmachi to Little Tokyo, Asian America, where did you go? Did, acid trips become antacids? Did freedom of speech become freebasing? Did love-ins become safe sex? Did zero population growth become 2.1, kids? Did encounter groups become your therapist? Did Kent State become real estate? Did communes become cul-de-sacs? Did Motown become Bobby Brown? Asian America, where have you gone? Don't you know that it's a new dawn? I see you out there, assimilating faster than the sound of a 300ZX. Built more powerful than the human race. Able to leap interest rates in a single bound. Asian America, can you be found? I see you out there in neon bright body glow spandex. Aerobicizing your cellulite off. Pumping up 24 hours a day at Gold's. Universal sweat pouring down those salon tan ultraviolet bodies. I see you out there. Oh, these Asian faces in the trendiest places. Let's take Biff and Muffy to that Thai barbecue. Oh, they love Cajun Korean. Oh, they love French Japanese too. Or what about a little Via Tex-Mex? Little Hunan, little Sichuan? We have everything for the little fun. And as racism hits an all-time high, Asian America, don't say Thai. Because they want tonsus, they want scrolls, they want culture, they want calligraphy, they want a Pachapiri Futong. It's like a white flower day sale at Macy's. And don't you know they got a yen for the Zen? Come on, Asian America. Don't be afraid to be men.
Oh, hi. It was nice to meet you. Maybe you'd like to dance. Okay. Well, that's okay. Sorry, you can't take the chance. I got a briefly red Infinity. Sorry, I'm allergic to dairy products, especially cheese. Oh no, it's Asian American Rain Man disease! Hey Frank, how you doing? You know, I'm on Interstate 80. Just did a quick lunch. It's a new place, you know,
Dollar Lunch.
All right, let me take out the old day runner and check. Oops, got another call, Frank. Be back in a sec. Are you still there, babe? Right, okay. I got a meeting with my broker at 2. Then at 3, I got a condo review. Tell you what, why don't you call me in my car phone at 4, because by 3:30, you know I'm out the door. Better yet, why don't you beat me on my beeper at 6? Yeah, we'll do cocktails with my accountant. He's got some great tax-saving tricks. Right. Chow mein, baby. Yeah. I see they got Stuckies and Mayfair next to frijoles and rice. You think that maybe Lucky's got some third-world mice? I see that Safeway has udon and sake. They got a yakitori section right next to Isemeyake. You know, America really doesn't want a Hugo, but they'll stand in line for a new Mazda, because there's a new Shogun at Rockefeller Plaza. I see all you Asians all moving to the suburbs, all hoping to hide. Let's color you white and take the kids for a ride. Let's buy a new house with a tennis court and pool. Let's get mom a maid and send the kids to private school. And their daughter's a cheerleader, and she's sweet, 16. And in a couple years, don't you think she should run for cherry blossom queen? And she shops in the malls, and she'd like a new dress. She'd like a new figure on American Express. She's an Asian princess. She'll take your heart to heaven. Look into her eyes. We'll have film at 11. Now, her brother's a tough one to truly figure out. He's got blonde hair and wants to be a Boy Scout. His mind's on video games and waxing his car. He invests in gold, though this boy will go far. And he tries to fit in and be one of the guys. But the weirder it gets, the harder he tries. The harder he tries, the worse he looks. Cause even his girlfriend calls him a gook. You see, living in the suburbs, it ain't too easy. Come back to the city, we'll make you real sleazy. We'll change your hairstyle and give you a beat. And in a couple months, our Boy Scout will talk street. Or you wanna stay in the white man's heaven, playing with yourself at 7-Eleven. Hello, Asian America! This is your wake-up call! We're prime time now, so come on! Let's get on the ball! Cause Saturday night is live with Miss Connie. Pat Morita's new sensei, he's finally making some big money. And the Forbidden City's new host is Arthur Dong. Have some tea and dim sum with Mr. Wayne Wong. An emperor of an actor is a guy named John Lone. James Hong's eyes come from the Twilight Zone. David Wong's middle name has been changed to Tony. Michael Jackson's new label is now owned by Sony. And Peter Wang's laser man is scaling that Great Wall. And Phil Katana makes Asian America stand tall. And if it wasn't for actors like Mako and Nancy Kwan, James Shigeta, Key Luke, George Takei, and Philip Vaughn, if it wasn't for Nobu McCarthy, Yuki Shimoda, and Jack Su, we would never have a chance to do what we do. James Wong Hao, John Okada, Carlos Bulasar, and Bruce Lee are all born again in the likes of Kingston Tan Uno and Okazaki. Now, we do the news on every television station. All these Asian American faces across the nation, Trish Toyota, Emerald Ye, Joanne Shimine, and Wendy Takuya. And that's the way it was. Good night. From Buddha. Main stage, which is going to be opening
a new show, June 13th, called Madame Mao's Memory, starring Kim New York. We got two more performances of Buddha on Sunday at 3:30 and 7:30. So you can tell about 50 of your friends there, you know. Well, you see it. We'll squeeze a few more chairs in here for them. No, thank you very much for a great audience.
Dub, 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 dub.
Insist for this label of imitation.
Buy from reputed dealers only.
We can do it.